So I was born in Calgary, and my background is Métis, and my ancestors were deeply involved with the events that happened that brought Manitoba into Confederation. My great-great-great-grandfather was Louis Riel's cousin, and they worked closely, and it was a very impressive time. And so our family's been involved in that for, the whole distance. And so I've been very curious. I grew up very curious about culture and different cultures and what it means to be Métis. And so I've always been inspired by learning the cultures of others, And so when I finished university, I moved to Asia and I started working over there and learning the different cultures. And I didn't know why I left at the time, And I think when I look back at this book, I had certain struggles myself fitting into the workplace, making relationships work in the workplace, but I didn't really get into any professional work at the time. So I met my wife in Macau. We had kids there and we moved back to Canada. And I kind of had that reverse culture shock. I don't know if you've ever experienced that where you've been away from your own culture for a long time, you move back. And and I came back to Canada. I started because I had to learn how other cultures worked when I lived there. Otherwise, I couldn't succeed. It was very different, not having worked before in Asia, in Korea, Japan. So I had good friends that said, Matt, this is what you have to do. If you want to succeed here, this is how you got to interact with people. This is how you've got to treat people. And so I was very grateful for all the support they gave me. And I never thought about understanding those rules. When you're born into a culture, you learn rules by osmosis as you grow older. You don't really think about it. But I started to look at, the importance of understanding culture. And so when we came back to Canada, I started to see, that Canadian workplace culture that I think that I struggled with a little bit. And then as I was reintegrating into Canada, I was working with a lot of international professionals that were trying to get started, and they were running into the same thing. They were running into these roadblocks and barriers to their own success. So as I worked with them, I started to realize, okay, what is it that we're missing? And so this book kind of came together, and the idea was the audience is multiple audiences, really. It's for me, a younger me. I wish I could have had that information you said, when you first came to Canada. I wish I would have had that when I was 18. So I think of that, and I also want my kids to learn about that, and I want high school students to learn about it. But also, I have friends that were born and raised in Canada that struggle with their jobs. And this is for them too. They've come to me and they said, Matt, I've worked at this company for 10 years and I'm not moving forward, or I'm getting laid off. What's happened to me? And so this is for them too. So it's, and of course, newcomer professionals, definitely, but it's really for multiple audiences. Anybody that's interested in learning about things they might have missed that have gotten in the way of their success. And so that's been my focus now for the last 10 years, is working with individuals, working with leaders, training leaders. I wrote another book, Would You Hire You? Which is because people would read this book and they say, thanks, Matt. Now I get the rules. Things are going well. I want to get promoted. I want to move into management. What do I need to know? So that was Would You Hire You? Was the next book. Things that companies are looking for and leaders they want to promote.